These guys may look a little like astronauts in their moon suits. And this may look like a centrifuge used in astronaut training. But in reality, these are workers finishing up a 20-year effort to replace and improve Seattle City Light's hydroelectric turbines. City Light has spent nearly $64 million in that time, but is expected to get a big net payback of nearly $112 million over the life of the upgraded equipment. Water-powered turbines are the big difference between hydroelectric generation and all other ways of making electricity. Water stored in a higher elevation is directed down onto the blades of the turbine, which then spins the generator that makes the power. The more efficient the turbines, the more electricity produced. The Skagit and other hydro project turbines have been producing power for a long time, some since the 1920s. Almost all of those have now been reworked and improved, and this one at Gorge Powerhouse is the last. Unit 24 has been in operation since the early 1960s and is in the final upgrade planned in this round of work.
Yeah, we're hoping to get a nice little jump in efficiency between this and the old one. Plus also, we should be able to run at a higher power with this new one than we did with the old one. We'll use less water to generate the same amount of power.
Bob Fuchs is the engineer overseeing the work on the Gorge unit, which includes the new improved turbine runner, as well as the repair work on the rest of the generator. It's anticipated this will improve generator 24 from 80 to 100 megawatts. One of the odder jobs is the use of a piece of equipment that requires a machinist to ride round and round, making small adjustments to a cutting edge.
It's actually called a boring bar, and what that operation is for is to machine the existing surfaces in the turbine area to accommodate some of the new parts that we're going to be putting into Unit 24.
This device is an innovation by City Light machinists who are doing much of the work in the turbine rebuilds.
We have a lot of old machinery that needs a constant 10 or 11 care to keep it going. A lot of the parts were made back in the early 20s and no longer available. So we will reverse engineer what's broken and upgrade it and make it to today's standards in our shop.
That has given a lot of expertise to City Light's machinists who must make spare parts for the older equipment. That also gave them a leg up in the competition to rebuild the utility's 18 turbine runners during the latest upgrade. Although some specialty jobs are being done by outside contractors, the bulk of the rebuilds are performed by City Light workers who bid against companies from around the world.
And we came out about $500,000 lower than the next lowest competitor. That was competing throughout the world, even as far as China had bid on it. So all the equipment that we have at the shop we've collected through the years has allowed us to compete with the outside world.
McConnell says the work should be wrapped up by this fall.
We know the system. We work well with the other crews that are here already. And the main thing is we're concerned about the quality that we're going to be here, the machine's going to be here, and when we leave, we want it to be the best it can be and hopefully run another 50 years without any problems.
Peter Clark, reporting for Seattle City Light.